Well, shit. I can't believe this turn of events. DCEU roller coaster, indeed. Literally, I think this might even have been yesterday, maybe the other day, but I was like, you saw me tweet about it, who I was rooting for, and I was like, you know, Janelle Monáe is Black Canary, and Kristen Milioti for Huntress, so amazing, and USS Callister. Like, what a great way to go with Huntress, right? I was like, damn, maybe Margot Robbie is a good producer. That's a girl gang that I can get behind. That's a girl gang worthy of a movie. And that can maybe, I can't believe I was thinking, it was too good to be true, but I was like, that could maybe be as good as Gotham City Sirens, right? Seriously, I had a Margot Robbie apology all planned. But I was right, and it brings me no joy that she has instead picked Jurnee Smollett-Bell as Black Canary and Mary Elizabeth Winstead as Huntress. Aw. All right, so I think that the explanation has to be that Margot Robbie just doesn't want the competition, because they're not only better actresses for the roles, but she was considering them. They made it to the finals. Janelle Monáe apparently like refused to test, but that's whatever. So what? She shouldn't have to test. She's Janelle Monáe. But you know, they were there. They were on the list. They were names that were in front of Margot Robbie. So for her to go, well, those actresses instead, I think she's just like, you know, I don't want to risk anybody overshadowing me in what is my movie, right? Now, the movie, of course, could still turn out great. I'm not ready to write off Birds of Prey. Let's see how they look in their costumes. Let's see what Cathy Yan can do, right? Is she going to Chad Stileski it up visually? That could be really cool. And I asked you recently what you'd be more interested in seeing for Valentine's Day 2020. Birds of Prey comes out the week before Valentine's Day, Bond 25 on Valentine's Day. But make no mistake, Warner Brothers doesn't want to directly go up against Bond, but they're hoping that they'll get like the people who don't see it opening weekend to see it for Valentine's Day, or you'll see it twice in 2 weeks, which I could see a lot of us doing, quite frankly, because it is a pretty good Valentine's Day choice. But in terms of the poll, well, before this casting was announced, let's just say Birds of Prey's first mission was a resounding victory, right? They blew Bond out of the water, to the shock of many of you. Now, Smollett-Bell, she does have a great look, right? She's the wild card here. We could end up saying she's fabulous, right? But I don't know if she's strong enough. It feels like we just did this with Zazie Beetz in terms of race-bending a character. Zazie Beetz, I would like to add, was very good, but not given enough of a role to really make a strong impression. But she's in the Joker movie. Oh, we're going to talk about the Joker movie in a moment. So Zazie Beetz has gone on to make another movie, to live another day. Good for her. But this kind of just seems like the same. And I think that Smollett-Bell, at least so far, doesn't have that strong enough, vibrant enough persona to counter the whitewashing complaints with Black Canary. I think she's a great role to racebend, quite frankly, because as I said, there's too much like Margot Robbie's Harley Quinn, visually, the way they've changed Harley Quinn. You can't have two cheesecake blondes standing next to each other. I just don't think it works. So I was behind this. I made a video about it, and I was quite surprised in the comments how many of you were adamantly, even those of you who are also of color, were very, very against changing the ethnicity of Black Canary. So to make that work, you need an actress that no one cannot like Zendaya, who I think is great, and then also Janelle Monáe. I think Janelle Monáe could have beat back the disappointment in changing the way Black Canary looks. Smollett-Bell just seems like she's just too soft. But maybe she'll surprise us, and maybe it'll be a juicier role than Domino. As for Mary Elizabeth Winstead, though, the only surprising that she's done lately is steal away Ewan McGregor from his family. I mean, did you know about that? That's not so great. And I would like to say that, yes, Mary Elizabeth Winstead is talented. I think she's a very talented and likable actress, no matter even what she did personally. You know, sometimes relationships run their course. I don't know what happened within the McGregor household. But anyway, I think that Mary Elizabeth Winstead has had her chance. We know what we can do, and we've seen her do it many, many times. It's just not as exciting. So with this casting, though, rest assured, this is going to be the Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn show, which I do think, by the way, could still sell a lot of tickets. I think Margot Robbie has turned out to be very, very, very well cast in this role, but this movie better have some teeth, because it's coming after the Joker film. And the Joker film's also all over the place, but when the Joker film so far is working, it really works to the degree that people are like, let's just stay with this. So are people going to want to yo-yo back to the Suicide Squad stuff that David Ayer did? People might be like, I want a new Harley now, right? I mean, she's not going to match with the Joker that a lot of people could potentially be falling in love with before her movie hits theaters. Just a couple of months difference, actually. So we'll see. I mean, it's not only Margot Robbie's fault, but Warner Brothers is kind of like, you know, dividing and conquering themselves too. But I'm deeply disappointed that this is who they went with. And I'm holding it against Margot Robbie. I mean, I'm not saying again that I won't like the movie, but she had an amazing cast there. She had a game-changing cast, and she opted against it. I don't like, I think this is the problem sometimes with having people produce their own movies. They don't have their own situation is their primary concern instead of the fans and the property. So it's really, really, I'm disappointed, palpably so. I'm sure you can, it's radiating off the screen. So I'm very curious to hear your thoughts down below. And now that you know this casting, do you change your vote a little bit with Bond? Of course, we have to see how that comes together. That's also a wild card. Why Hollywood? Why so many shots in the dark, for Pete's sake? It's crazy. All right, write your thoughts down below. Thank you for talking this over with me. We can get through this together. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.